Granny Strikes Back, A Secret Agent Granny Mystery by Harper Lin, read by Sara Morsey. Chapter 1. Getting attacked by an assassin is not my idea of the best way to prepare for a first date. A visit to the hair salon, putting on a nice dress, and making sure my reading glasses are in my purse so I can decipher the menu? Yes, most certainly all good things to do. I remember enough about dating etiquette to know what needs to be done, even if I haven't been on a first date for 40 years. Times have changed, of course, and I've changed too. The last time I had a date, Jimmy Carter was president, and I could read a menu without any help. There was no internet dating. I didn't have gray hair back then, and I didn't get guilty feelings every time I looked at the picture of my late husband. But one thing I certainly do remember about dating in the 1970s was that part of the preparation certainly did not include wiping a stranger's blood off the bathroom floor. I'm Barbara Gold, age 70, 5 feet 5 inches, eyes blue, hair gray, weight none of your business. Specialties, undercover surveillance, small arms, chemical weapons, Middle Eastern and Latin American politics, current status, retired widow and grandmother. Addendum to current status. Realizing just how much I need the few people left in my life. My son and his family had flown off for a week's holiday in the Bahamas, leaving me alone with my small circle of friends. I immediately felt lonely. Not that my friends are bad people. They're all quite nice and pleasant. It's just that they're all old, some considerably older than I am, and frankly, most of them are quite boring. Cheerville encourages that in its citizens. Nice, pleasant, and boring. There was one notable exception to the boredom, Octavian Perry. I met him at a seniors' yoga class at the Cheerville Senior Center. He was by far the least senior of anyone at seniors' yoga. I guessed his age at about my own, although he looked younger thanks to regular exercise and a healthy lifestyle. He had a lovely full head of hair, all gray, of course, and his deepest wrinkles were smile lines. Octavian smiled a lot. It was infectious. I was smiling already as I applied my makeup, examining myself in the bathroom mirror. He was due any minute to whisk me off for dinner at the Adawa restaurant, a new Ethiopian place. He had billed it as wonderfully exotic. No, Octavian, eating at a middle-class immigrant's bistro in a leafy suburb isn't exotic. Grilling camel meat while taking mortar fire in the Sahara is exotic. But nice try. I chuckled to myself, wondering how Octavian would react to a situation like that. Just then, Dandelion crawled up my leg, ruining the fifth pair of pantyhose that week. The little tortoiseshell kitten had surprisingly painful claws, especially when she decided I was something to climb on. "Oh, do behave," I scolded her, shaking her off. She landed on the tile and looked up at me. "Hungry?" I asked. She only stared. I decided not to get into a staring contest with a cat. It's like playing drinking games with a Russian. You will always lose. "I'll feed you before I leave, and stop turning me into a batty old lady who talks to her cat. I'm trying to recapture my youth here." Just then, Dandelion whipped around and stared out the bathroom door, eyes going wide. She bolted out the door, stared at something towards the back of the house, and shot away in the other direction. I paused. That had been odd, and a lifetime of training had drilled into me that odd was bad. Odd could get you killed. Then I felt it. The faintest breeze of night air. I had already closed all the windows in anticipation of leaving for the evening, so I shouldn't be feeling that. Unless someone had opened a window. But I couldn't hear a thing. While my sight wasn't what it used to be and my knees were going, my hearing remained just as sharp as ever. Whoever had just broken into my home knew how to move silently. That suggested this wasn't some clueless teen acting rebellious, or some clumsy druggie desperate to steal my TV for a fix. I glanced around my bathroom for a weapon. I had maybe 5 seconds to arm myself. Safety razor? I didn't have time to break it open and make a proper blade out of it. Soap dish? Good for a club, but a bit small. Nail file? No good unless I hit an eye or shoved it up a nostril. I've done the nostril thing. It has an immediate and quite horrible effect on the target, but requires an excellent aim, and my reflexes aren't what they used to be. Hairspray. A nice big metal can with a hard edge on the bottom. Pretty nasty to spray into the eyes, too. I grabbed it and turned on the tap in the sink. Then I got behind the bathroom door and closed it partway. Luckily for me, the door opens inward, and the sink is not visible from the hallway outside. Also, the mirror was set in such a way that you couldn't see my reflection from the doorway. These little details are essential in a battlefield, and my bathroom was about to become one. I stood there, gripping the hairspray bottle and trying to hear above the rush of the water. Of course, I heard nothing, but the running tap would lead the intruder right into my little trap. Even when he came through the door, I didn't hear him. He was a blur of motion, rushing into the bathroom and going for the sink. All I saw was a man clad all in black, with a balaclava covering his face and tight black leather gloves on his hands. Just as he stopped, realizing he'd been had, I clonked him right behind the ear with the hairspray. I brought the hard edge of the bottom of the can precisely down on a pressure point. Even at my age, I'm up for one good hit, and I sure gave it to him. Any normal adult male would be laid out on the floor unconscious. This was not a normal adult male, and he didn't take his cue to drop out of the fight. Very discourteous. I did have the satisfaction to see him stagger forward and grab hold of the sink with his free hand to steady himself. His other hand gripped a Bowie knife with a serrated edge. Yes, serrated, like I was a steak or something. When I was younger, I always found being looked at by men like I was some piece of meat to be very insulting. I still didn't like it, although now it wasn't so much insulting as downright frightening. The intruder spun around and took a swipe at me with that serrated edge. Luckily, I'd stunned him enough that his aim was off and he missed me by an inch. I didn't give him time to improve his aim. I sprayed him full in the eyes with the hairspray. He grunted and took a step back, allowing me to exit the door first. What a gentleman. I ran, or what passed for running these days, to my bedroom, where I had something infinitely better than a can of hairspray, a 9mm automatic pistol that I kept in a drawer in the bedside table. Within a moment, I heard his heavy footsteps coming after me, running much faster than I could, and no longer caring about silence. I sprayed behind my shoulder while looking as I hurried down the short hallway to my bedroom, then tossed the can behind me. It hit him in the face with a satisfying clonk, but it didn't slow him down. The bedroom door slamming in his face was much more effective. The door and the entire doorframe shook from the impact. It brought up memories of Cliff. Cliff had been a fellow operative. Once we shared a hotel room while on assignment in Nicaragua, posing as husband and wife. Cliff decided that we should method act, so I kicked him out and told him to sleep in the hallway. When he tried to bluster back inside his room, I slammed the door right in his face. Cliff had gotten the message. This guy would not. I clicked the ridiculously weak lock shut and hurried for my gun. Just as I thought, a second later, my assailant gave the door a good swift kick and it crashed open. The average American door is ridiculously weak, a downside of living in the stable country. He strode into the bedroom, knife held high, and bolted out again as I pulled out my gun. Me, being a responsible gun owner, saved his life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.